Hey guys, Andrew here, also in the Slayer Rockety 6, and today we're going to be doing Top Factions of the Week. I know it's been a little while. I am joined with the co-owner of the server, and I'm going to let him announce himself to you guys. Say hello.
Hello, I'm MDG555. You can also know me as Maurice.
And anyway. Yeah, so he's going to be co-hosting this little video, and I'm a little bit laggy right now because I have Skype running at the same time, and ScreenFlow running, and Minecraft running, so if it's a little bit laggy, I apologize, but let's get started. So, let's go with number 5.
Yep, Warp Top 5. This one was a very nice faction, actually.
Yep. By the way, we're currently at spawn, if you guys are wondering. He's going to TP me over to the faction. So, I'm teleporting to it. There we go. So, what's the name of this faction?
This one is Freemason. They actually did a lot more upgrading than what was here before.
Holy crap, they have a ton of emeralds.
Yeah.
Wow. That's a lot. Okay,
yep,
so
Ender Slaying, really. This was changed from what it was last time I was here, actually.
Yep, I made it daytime so viewers with terrible monitors could see a little bit better. As you guys could see, they made a little wall around. Not too helpful, but at least it's a wall, so keep some people out, as long as they ain't got ender pearls. And it looks like they have quite a bit of land. The wall kind of ends around over here.
But actually, it goes a little farther off towards my direction, because they have their farms and a little hut with, four more beacons over here.
Wow. It's a lot of stuff. Try not to put too many beacons, because it kind of does lag a bit, peoples. But,
yeah,
a lot of nice stuff here. And I'll show off the inside of this a little bit. I don't want to show too much, because I don't want people to know where all their stuff is. But,
I barely went on the inside.
Yeah, so, pretty nice. Again, this isn't a creative server, it's a faction server. So, building a hut in itself is, like, way more than building a modern mansion and, like, a creative server and stuff. So, this was all, like, handmade.
Oh, hey, they got a mushroom or whatever it's called. Don't even know what those
and
are
iron
called.
Golems. They must have gotten quite the villagers to have gotten all this emerald. Or they probably bought it through the shop.
They probably went through the shop.
Yeah, still, the shop's quite expensive. So, you have to either get a ton of experience or a ton of, yeah, probably killed thousands of people, but again, pretty powerful faction. And let's go to number 4.
Oh, whoops. Wrong command.
And real quick, oh, look, here is, I guess, the owner of it. Hello.
That's one of them.
Yeah, one of the Freemason peoples. And
okay, now this one is the tricky one. This one, I'm just going to wait until I can see, because I can't. Oh, there you are. This one was the tricky one, actually. This one had a trick to it. Come down here. You just got to come down here. There's a little hole down here. You just drop right down.
Oh.
All the way down. This one is a very, very neat faction because of this little trick. I would not have found this if it weren't for that chicken.
Holy crap. What's the name of the faction?
This faction is Drifters, I believe it was.
I don't think it's a very good idea that we just told people their name now that I think about it. They can go on the GPS map thing, and now they'll be like, right there. That's where they're at.
Whoops.
Yeah. Well,
I blame you.
They won't be able to. It's underground, so there's no way they could get in as long as they cover up with, like, a piece of stone.
This was very nicely played out in terms of how well hidden it was, because I would never have found it if it weren't for that little chicken just drowning in that one spot.
That's the thing that I love, is it's like a nothing faction, yet you go inside and it's like, holy crap, there's so much to it.
So, yeah.
See, these are like the best survivalists. They last like forever because no one knows where they're at. Plus, again, if you build underground, there's nothing anyone can do to go inside. Like, unless if they got creepers to blow the stuff up, but again, it's underground. They'll get stuck unless if they have a ton of ender pearls to waste, so.
They even have an AFK pond right here. Like, look at this. They have an AFK station, and it's very well. It works completely and utterly. Like, look at this. You can even go up. Whee!
Wow.
It works. I don't know how, but I love it.
That's actually pretty smart. AFK station, just sit here when you're AFK and your power comes. You get more power by being on the server a lot, so I'm guessing literally just stay here, do this.
Yeah, that's what they do.
And that, no wonder, that's actually genius. So that's how they have so much power.
That's how this faction has actually quite a bit of power.
Holy crap. These are
But this is only top 4.
Wow.
Top 1 and top 2 really came down to the pinch. I'm going to be honest with you on that one. Top 4, or top 1 and 2 came down to a pinch.
Okay, well, take me to top 3. I'm just showing this off. This is still pretty cool. Probably just make like a billion
top
of these.
Top three actually belongs to my faction.
Which is?
McFaction.
MC Faction?
Yes, it is. MC Faction.
MC Faction. See, that's what we thought. But you said McFaction. I'm like, see, oh, well, we've been saying it wrong for ages.
I spent every ounce of my money on all this obsidian just to case it in.
Holy crap.
This literally goes really high.
Wow.
The whole reason, the biggest reason why I did this is because really TNT cannons attacking the cobblestone really got annoying from Haggis Army. So
you literally...
I just went and I bought it all and world edited it.
Wow.
I literally spent maybe 4 days in the end just hunting Enderman. Anyway, just do, I'm just going to go into descend and teleport you inside.
Yeah, and by the way, guys, no one else has creative or anything besides MDG. So if you guys were wondering, there's no creative on the server besides us because we're like the owners and we need to fly around and see stuff.
See, a friend of mine made a lava lamp actually at the top of this.
Wow, that's a lot of stuff. I was also going to say, after like 30-something blocks, I think it's 36 blocks, no, the Ender Pearl will just come back down, so... Unless if someone's like, if you claim a ton of land around it, then you're set. But it all depends on you. But holy crap, this is epic though.
Yep, there are small, there is one way in that does not have a door, just let me see if I can find it. Where is it? Here it is. I'm just going to teleport you over again. Just right here. This is where we put our archery range, actually.
I see.
Made an archery range for enchanted bows and non-enchanted bows.
You know what you could do is
and
put...
And we've got a skeleton issue in here, so we got to put more lighting.
Here, if you put, like, a wooden button, you could have, like, a torch or something there. Just for the coolness of it. I don't know if the torch thing will work perfectly. Let me try it out. Put a torch right there, and... Did I put the button there, or the... Oh, wait, no. Slash?
No, you don't have faction bypass on.
There we go. I got it. I could do what I want. Ah, doesn't work. But here, I got an idea. If you get yourself a lamp, put the lamp, let me break this block in there, and then put the button. When you hit it, it'll light up.
Yeah. Very nice.
But it has to be a wooden one. The stone one doesn't work, so. Yeah.
Okay.
Be an archer. Actually want to try that. Let me get a bow. Bow. And some arrows. I don't know if I need arrows.
I might let you use my bow, but it's in the ender chest right now.
Yeah. Wait. Oh, I don't know if I shot or not. Oh, yep.
You got it. You got it.
Yep. Minecraft Pro. Double shot. Okay, let's go on to the next faction. We are at number 2, right?
Yes. Now, this one has multiple different parts to it. Whoa, okay, where am I? What happened here?
The faction die.
No, it's just... I don't know what happened. I can't see the boat. There was a giant boat. Oh, well. There was multiple parts to this one anyway.
So we're going to have to go to faction number 1.
No, as I said, this top 2 has multiple different parts to it.
Holy crap. Okay. Well, I'll go...
That added on to it. Like... Here's part of it right here.
Okay.
And then there's one more part. This is Wanderers.
I've heard the Wanderers. They're pretty massive.
They're huge. They have places all over the map.
Yeah. Wasn't their title, we literally go everywhere?
Pretty much. Yeah. We wander and build everywhere.
I haven't noticed.
Like, look at this. This is huge. This is just one part of their entire faction.
Yeah, I know, like, they build a gigantic airship.
What made it the clicker for me instantly saying it has to be number 1 or 2 was... The giant boat that was supposed to be there that's not no more.
They might have burned it or something. Holy crap.
Anyway,
they even
I'm going to the next one.
Just give me a sec. I need to like... Well, you can go there. I'll meet you or TP me there in just a bit. I want to like keep showing this off. Holy crap, this is really nice though. For a faction server, it's really nice.
Some of this creativity. Like this other one, it's in the air again. Like this... The boat I was talking about was, like, I would say 300 blocks in the air.
Wow. I'm just looking at this. It's like, I think they're still working on it. It's like a church or something. But it's nice that they're building, like, really
decent. Still under development, too.
And they still got, like, a really good wall. This is a really good piece of land.
It is.
And there's several other people here. I just love this. They actually have a good community going on here. I see, like, people just working together and all that. That's why I love this server. That's why I made the faction server, because I wanted people to actually work together and be friends with each other.
Yeah. And they also raid with one another and everything else.
Yeah.
Faction's actually one of three that's actually in a huge raid. They're literally going from faction to faction, just raiding.
That's gotta be fun. See, and even if you don't wanna, if you have, like, the fear of being raided, you could always just join a faction, gain some power in the future, just leave it or ally it, so. But I just wanted people to have the same Minecraft experience that I had when I first played Minecraft, but it's impossible to do that in the server unless you have, like, a plugin like factions. So, TP me to the next one.
Okay, this is still number two here, but this was another nice piece that I found, actually completely by accident.
It's like a massive sky castle.
I'm actually in the middle of building one myself.
It's a massive sky castle.
Yeah. I'm actually in the middle of making my own sky castle, but it's not that big just yet. It's actually not even close to being finished. We're maybe about 20% done.
What's the name of
this? I have one other person helping me with it.
Damn. What's the name of this faction, though?
One is still Wanderers.
Wow.
As their faction description says, we wander and build everywhere.
Holy crap. We should gift them, like, some power just, like, for fun. For, like, that's what we do sometimes randomly, guys. We, like, give factions a little bit of power just extra when they do, like, amazing jobs. But I think as a prize for being, like, number two, they should get some gifts. Like a gifted rank to keep their stuff going. But this is really nice.
Yeah, like, see, look at this. I don't think the lava was there last time I was here, actually.
We'll go ahead and patch that up for them. They might have had a little TNT creeper explosion problem. Or not. Actually, I have no idea. Where's the lava?
I found the source block.
One random block. The problem with lava is its physics are really messed up, so it might take a couple days for this thing to go all the way back down. So let's go to the next faction.
Oh my lord, I keep messing up the warps.
Holy crap, we got
wrong,
like,
one again.
Wow, this is like extreme. I don't understand how people make such amazing stuff, though. They had a whole entire spiral.
Now this was the clincher. It was close. But in the end, me and CM Rig, who helped me decide this, decided Destiny was the best.
So this is number one?
This is number one. And we made the decision under the assumption that Haggis Army did not own half their land. Like, if they had all their land back, this hands down would be number one. They got two mob spawners, for crying out loud.
Well,
this one's one. The tall one over there is another one.
Wait, where's the tall one?
The tall one is over here next to this tree thingy, I think this is.
Okay.
This is another mob spawner right here. I think this one's still in development.
Oh, that's what these things are.
Yeah, because they spawn mobs inside and they just drop to their death.
That's pretty smart.
Yep. I think these were actually based off of someone's Skyblock adventure craft or something.
Yeah. I know I've made spawners before in an island when we were doing island survival a while ago, like an old series I did. But yeah, it's still pretty epic. I love how they got, like, a little house here and everything.
Yeah.
It's a pretty smart idea, though. That's a challenge to someone that I want to, like, set out. Make a gigantic jungle tree faction where it's just a bunch of jungle trees and other trees alike. Like, make a nice perimeter, put a bunch of walls out, make sure you claim all the land so no one can go and burn it. And actually, that would be a big problem. That'd be the most fire hazardous faction ever.
Exactly.
It would all burn down. Oh, man. Oh, my cat's just laying on my foot. She's so cute. I hope that's her face and not her ass, but... Yeah, looking at this, the design of this is actually very smart. Like, they won't be, like, just the wall, the way that it goes vertical, I guess, keeps people from, like, just climbing up. But it's not that tall, but it's still pretty good.
No, it's what made me just look. I didn't even look on the inside of their bases yet, like their mine and everything, because just the outside, this area here, was just so beautiful. It's very good eye candy. Just very nice on the eyes, in other words.
And I love the walls, still. And, like, they're not tall, but the sections over there, you could, like, have your arrows out and ready to fire. It looks like they're probably going to make this taller here.
I think that was the point.
Wow, they've got a giant moat. No wonder they got a ton of resources. They must have taken forever to mine that out.
Yeah.
Wow. And that's all, like, legit mining, too. That wasn't world edit.
Yep. This was one. Every single faction here was 100% legit, including my obsidian cage, because I bought it all before world editing it.
Yeah.
I did that to save the time, because that would take days to do.
Yeah, but besides his, everything else is handmade. Plus, he doesn't go into combat that much on his faction when he has op, but his people do. So.
When I'm in creative, I'm never in combat. I'm just flying around.
Yeah. Just for the
looking
people
looking at the factions, determining whether they're good for the next top five.
Yep. And also doing a couple of server management stuff.
Yep. Managing the jail, the hackers, everything like that.
They have a Christmas tree, it looks like.
Yeah.
But yeah, okay guys, I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. I hope you all enjoyed. If you guys want to join the server, you could hit the annotation in the bottom, or not the bottom, but the top left. And yeah, it's free to join. You could go to the website. The IPs are on the top page. Of course, you can get some ranks. They will help you with your faction, and they basically help keep the server up. The servers, like, we've got three servers now. We have a third one, which is in development, but yeah, it costs a ton of money to run, like $300+.
The third one is going to be amazing, by the way.
Yeah, we'll talk about that in a later video. We'll keep that surprise for right now. But yeah, check that out, and tune in next week for the next epic top factions every Wednesday, and that's basically it. Hope you guys enjoyed, and you want to say a couple last words?
Join us. We need more people.
Yep.
You'll get some cookies.
Yeah, you'll get some cookies. And that's basically it. We'll talk to y'all later. Bye.
Bye-bye.